We have a very special guest with us, Dr. Santosh Nadimpalli, professor at IIT Kanpur, Department of Mathematics. A very warm welcome to you, sir, on our
channel. Thank you.
It's an honor to have you. We have few questions, and to begin with, we would love to know about your journey from school to ISI, then Europe, and now in IIT Kanpur.
Okay, so in school, I was just a very average student, but because of my family has some mathematicians in the academic circles. So I found that mathematics is my cup of tea. And I could do it all by myself. So I was just reading books at home. I had a lot of math books. So that subject, I could do it on my own, unlike other subjects. So I liked mathematics. But of course, like all children of my age group, wanted to be a IITian or something, but well, I got a very huge rank, so that did not happen. But I was very good at math, so I went to ISI, and so ISI was a great place to learn math. I had many great seniors who I could discuss math. My friends, they are a lot of influence on me. My batchmates, and then we all went to do PhD in various places. I went to Europe. So
how was your Europe experience compared to here?
So I don't think that is very different, because so if you do a PhD in, let's say, a place like TIFR or some research institute, well, of course, Europe has the constant upgrading. I would say if you are doing PhD in TIFR, Europe wouldn't have been very different experience, unlike many other places, perhaps in India. So there are places in India which are as good as place where I did my PhD. So say the place where I did PhD is one of the best places to do mathematics. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have a constant upgrading. I mean, they are very up to date with what is happening in the world, and you get to know various things. But you can also get in some places in India.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and Indian schools are also modeled based on these great Western schools.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there are some similarities. At the same time, maybe I would say if you are in such places in your West, your exposure would be much higher than what we find here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So for a school student who loves math, what path should they follow so that they can become a PhD scholar?
I'm not sure that one should aim to become a PhD scholar. I don't usually encourage that. But well, if your calling is for that, and if you really want to do mathematics, and if you don't consider various other preferences or preferences or your other commitments in life, and only want to do mathematics, and if you are, for example, if you can, you prove something at night and wake up in the morning and think that, oh, I made some mistake, then math is for your calling.
Yeah.
Then you should, for mathematics is about self-correcting, kind of a rigorous subject. If it is for you, then you should take it.
Sir, after clearing IIT JAM examination, how should a student decide which IIT or institute to join for MSc in mathematics?
Yeah, so this is a difficult question according to me. Of course, you would have preferences, geographical preferences.
Mm.
On the top of that, I would say you will have some interest in mathematics, like for example, you like analysis or you like algebra, very broadly, number theory or something. Then you look at the profiles of faculty, then see, certain subjects are represented in certain IITs, then you should prefer that, irrespective of geographical location.
So this is important one. During MSc, how should a student choose their specialization or research area in mathematics?
So if you have already a certain interest, that is good. But most students, I observe that they really don't have, even if they have certain interest, they are not sure, like they haven't followed up. So suppose you have certain interest. When I started my BMath or my undergraduate days, I was really interested in analysis, but that slowly fizzled out and I became an algebraist, sort of say. So you should ask your teachers. You should not be hesitate. You should not hesitate to consult your teachers You should solve problems from the famous books in each area. You approach your teacher saying, I have tried this problem, but I failed. Then no teacher, no professor here or anywhere else, I would say, will say, no, don't meet us.
Yeah.
I would say they would welcome you and they would help you to the extent they can.
So that is another question. For a regular college student in India, how can they prepare and apply for PhD abroad in mathematics?
So college student mean?
Like who's doing MSc.
MSc.
If they want to apply to abroad.
Okay, so I have a feeling that naturally BS students or undergraduates have a huge advantage for that.
Yeah.
In the reasons may be certainly that in India we take BS students after a very competitive exam and so on and so forth. But
those who are doing PG like MSc.
Yeah. So now when you come to PG level courses, the problem is manifold because, okay, let me first say that there is no need to apply outside India.
Yeah.
There are many of my colleagues and many other people who did their PhDs in this country and did much better mathematics than I am doing or any other person who did in their PhD in the West doing. So that doesn't mean that you should not go.
Mm.
Always going to other countries and looking at other mathematical cultures is an important part.
So it doesn't matter too much.
Well, it should not matter a lot, but yeah, certainly going and seeing other cultures will help your worldview or your mathematical view. So, okay, now how do we prepare for going outside? This is, so when you come to first year MSc, so you must have certain interest in mathematics. Either if you don't have any interest in particular subject, it becomes much harder.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you have to keep CPI higher and so people who are that is one part. So you must have some particular interest in some slightly advanced subject of mathematics, and you should keep in touch with professors constantly, reading something or solving problems and approaching them about how to, if you are stuck in some problem, etc., or talking about mathematics, about the things that you have solved or what you thought about theorems, etc. Because only when you interact with professors, they can judge your capabilities and so on. Now, what about there are logistic issues here?
Yes.
So by the end of first year, we should start preparing for GRE and other exams.
Yes.
You should also vet which places are good for you.
Yes.
Right? So which universities are good for you? And you should prepare a list of such universities, and you should prepare also a list based on your CPI and various things. So the planning should start just after first year summer.
Yes.
Then during winter, you take GRE, etc. And then in your second year winter season, you start applying.
Yes.
So this is a huge process. So you should be really prepared right after you should prepare yourself right after first year. So first year, you read as much as possible, develop some interest in mathematics, save. You should yourself know why you wanted to do mathematics, right?
Yeah.
So that should be clear from the student's viewpoint as well.
So one question, it's a little personal but interesting one. So you work on PID group and representation theory. How would you describe your research in a way a curious school student can understand?
So yeah, representation I can explain to a, let's say a school student, I mean as you, in your own words.
Yeah.
But representation theory of PID groups will require some motivation coming from number theory,
yes,
like modular forms, yes, and things like that.
Mm.
Representation theory is it's not very difficult to explain. It's like, for example, you study groups.
Yes.
So groups are something about symmetries of objects.
Yes.
For example, a square has certain symmetries. You can rotate and flip. So these operations are usually what mathematicians call as a group.
Mm-hmm.
And groups are sort of realized as transformations of some vector space,
mm-hmm,
or some plane or some real vector space, mm-hmm, Rn, etc. So when you try to write groups as matrices,
mm-hmm,
like for example quaternions, mm-hmm, we have famous matrices, MUC, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that process is called representation theory. When you write an abstract group in terms
so
of
better native, understanding of
yeah,
group
so,
theory.
Yeah, so to understand group from something that you know very well from matrices. That is the subject of representation theory.
Again, so very important. Many a student asked me, how should a student manage their time, courses and pressure during MSc to stay motivated and do well academically? Generally, IIT students feel this.
Can you repeat your question?
How should a student manage their time, courses and pressure during MSc to stay motivated and do well academically?
Yeah, this is, I would say from the time you enter IIT, you will have some compulsory courses and I think you should take the best books in that area. For example, you are doing Artin, Rudin, some Moncret or whatever, and you should solve problems and you should approach professors rather than your senior. You should approach professors and ask them, so here is my difficulty and what should I be doing and so on. Of course, you should always take hints from your senior, but I think the best person to advise how to manage your time, what courses you should be taking, and your career path, etc., would be teachers who are teaching you. And I strongly request people, especially MSc students, to approach people. You know, sometimes we also can't entertain too many students, but it's okay that you go and ask them and bother us as much as possible.
So it's the last question, sir.
But I think you should have your preferences right. So you can't be ace in everything. So once you develop certain interest in a particular subject, you concentrate on that particular subject with higher attention. Solving problems, reading in depth about that, thinking about it, your own example, asking questions, naturally occurring questions on the subject would be important.
That's the last one. What is your message for a student who love maths but feels scared of research or thinks it's too tough?
Yeah, so someone who loves mathematics would not even have that question, is what I think. So someone who loves math likes to do mathematics.
Yes.
Now why would somebody be fear research? One should know. If you fear research, then I don't think there is something called fearing research. It's just our mindset perhaps is like, okay, what will happen if I do research? Will I get a thesis in 5 years? I think these are the questions you should not think.
So is it because of taking subject, they take subject irrelevant, like they are not interested in particular X subject or they took it?
Course choices does really matter. This is why I suggest that for course choices, should go to your favorite teacher and ask him about, you know, or have a small discussion with him about what should I choose, etc. I think doing PhD might be scary. Of course, it was scary for me also. I think you should ask teachers and should not think about what will happen to my career. Such thoughts are not meant for academic inclined people. There's always uncertainty here. Like math, do math, be happy.
Thank you so much for joining us here on Formulas.
Thank you.
It was really great talking to you.
Yeah.